According to the American Diabetes Association, an estimated 1 out of every 3 people with diabetes over the age of 50 also have peripheral arterial disease, or PAD. PAD is most common in the legs and occurs when narrowed arteries reduce blood flow to your limbs. This results in poor circulation and can cause wounds to heal slower. Major advances have been made in the quest to build a better bandage. However, chronic wounds still affect approximately 6.5 million people in the United States, and the cost of care are expected to exceed the $50 billion mark this year. What if there was an imaging device designed for early intervention and predictive healing of chronic wounds? Here with more information is foot and ankle surgeon and podiatrist, Dr. Nouvong of UCLA Medical Group. Welcome, Dr. Nouvong.
Thank you so much for having me, Erica.
I am so happy to have you here. So let's jump right into it. What exactly is a chronic wound?
Sure. A chronic wound is a wound that does not heal by 50% within approximately 4 weeks with standard or good wound care.
And with the conditions that you see, how do they go hand in hand with chronic wounds?
Well, oftentimes my patients have diabetes and they have both peripheral neuropathy, which is the inability to sense pain, and also patients with peripheral arterial disease.
And so how does that affect the chronic wound?
So patients with peripheral neuropathy do not have the ability to sensate pain. Mm-hmm. So a small blister or a cut or sore in patients without peripheral neuropathy would actually heal because patients would either change their shoes or change the way they walk. But patients with peripheral neuropathy don't change the way they walk, or they don't change their shoes, so they actually worsen the wounds.
I see. And so what about those with PAD?
So PAD can be of two different forms: large vessels, where they bring the major blood flow, or small vessel disease, where the small vessels actually feed the cells that actually heal the wounds.
So then they're not getting the blood flow to the wound, is that it?
Well, there's two different problems. Either they're not getting enough blood flow to the wound, or once the blood flow gets to the wound in the small vessels, they may not be utilizing the blood appropriately. So basically, when blood flows through a tissue, you have oxygenated blood or oxyhemoglobin.
Okay.
If the tissue actually uses the oxygen for healing, it converts that into a deoxyhemoglobin.
So it's important to know what's happening at the site of the wound.
Absolutely. So it's important to know that there's blood flow that's converting the oxygen or utilizing it to metabolize, and then also be able to convert that into the deoxyhemoglobin.
Very interesting. So doctor, I hear you have some exciting news. You have a newly available imaging device right here to show us.
Yeah, the technology's been around since 2006, but the new system, the HyperView, is newly developed. This camera here can actually image a patient and look at the oxyhemoglobin and deoxyhemoglobin in patients' tissues.
So doctor, I understand that you currently are using this technology. Can you explain how to use it and how it's benefiting your patients?
Absolutely. So I use it 3 main ways. One, I will determine whether a wound is going to heal or not based on the results I get from the camera. Number 2, I can also predict whether a wound is going to develop or not. If I know something is going to develop, I will take preventive care. Additionally, the system will actually give me information about whether a wound has adequate perfusion or adequate circulation. For example, Erica, in this image here, the area that's red shows adequate blood flow, but the area that's blue here, which correlates with lower oxyhemoglobin and can correlate with poor wound healing. This was a wound. This area here may not heal at all because it does not have appropriate blood flow. And if my patient does not have enough circulation or inadequate perfusion, I would be able to refer that patient to a vascular specialist earlier.
Access Health caught up with Dr. Bauer Sumpio, professor at Yale University School of Medicine, in the sections of vascular surgery, interventional radiology, and cardiology to explain how he uses this technology.
As a vascular surgeon, it is important for me to be able to assess the amount of blood flow to the legs or to the foot. The current technologies that we have only assess the large vessels that go to the leg. We may have a good result in terms of our bypass surgeries that we do, and we may also have a good result if we do a balloon, angioplasty, or a stent into that leg. But we really have no way of knowing for sure that blood flow to that foot is adequate. The HyperView device has special advantage because of its portability, size, ease of use, and the ability to acquire data quickly. So in the operating room or in the cardiac suites, it's easy to use the device on the foot, confirm the segments of the foot that is lacking in perfusion, especially around the area of any ulceration. This way, immediately after the procedure has been done, while the patient is still on the table, we can repeat that assessment, and we can now determine whether or not the intervention that we did, either surgical or endovascular, has succeeded in restoring perfusion to that foot.
That is such great information. It sounds like this could be a real life changer for so many people. Doctor, in your opinion, what are some of the advantages of this technology?
Well, the system is basically like a camera, and it does not touch the patient. So patients with wounds will actually reduce the risk of infection because it does not touch the patient at all. Number two, I get immediate results, and I can discuss that with my patient. So if I can tell my patient whether their wound is going to heal or not, whether they need to go to advanced wound care, and also whether I need to send them to a vascular specialist. Additionally, it provides me clinical images that I can look at with my patient and discuss.
Doctor, thank you so much. This was truly educational today, and I think a lot of people are going to benefit from the information we shared. Where else can they go to get additional resources on this technology?
They can actually go to hypermed.com or ask their doctor if this is an appropriate test for them to have.
Wonderful. If you or someone you love is having a challenging time with wound care, diabetes, or PAD, you can find everything discussed here today on our website, accesshealth.tv, and don't forget to follow us on Facebook and Twitter. See you next time.